What's up, guys? Welcome back to Project Ozone 3. Today is something special. So, I've been working on our AE2 system. As you can see, we now have dense smart cables. We have more disk drives. You know, we're doing pretty good. But I came to a big of an issue earlier. I was looking for something, and I couldn't find it. And then I flew up. And I kind of realized on where we're living. So, I'm going to fix this. Now, I don't really know how to do time lapses. So, I'm just going to do like a before and after. And I'm going to organize all of this. And we're going to have little different islands going off in different directions. Because I really don't want to live on a one block slab in the middle of the air. So, this is what it looked like before. And this is the after. So, couple things. You'll notice that it doesn't look like I've changed a lot, but this is like 2 days worth of work. Mainly because I had to reset up everything. I had to rebuild the entire gravel sieving thing. I had to redo all the drawers. Had to redo all of the filters. Had to redo everything. So yeah. It's been rough, and I should have that off. So, as you can see, starting here, I upgraded two of our cobble gins. They're now diamond just to help keep up with everything. Almost every one of these storage drawers has upgrades in them. Some have more than one because of the amount of ores that we're getting now is just ridiculous. Like, it's just, it's wow. The iron here, like we have 9,000 iron ore chunks, so, and that's not counting everything I've already smelted, pulled out, transferred, yeah, it's ridiculous. So this is the first island that I made, and then I made a cool little bridge here, which I think looks cool. Oh, you get a little preview down below, and I moved our lava thing over here just to get it the fuck out of the way, and it's still just got a basic cobble gen. I don't use this very much, so I don't think we need to upgrade a lot of this. I did add one more crucible just to make it even, but we don't use this very much. Now, I used this a lot in Sky Factory 3, is why I went ahead and built this so early, is because I thought we would need it, but you don't. Because in Sky Factory 3, you can use magmatic generators from Ender.io. At Ender.io, is it the Sterling generators? Yeah, the Sterling generators. They're real easy to make because it's got the old school recipe, but the new ones take the industrial machine casing, which is a bunch of dye, and it's just, it's bad. And I made another little walkway. I love these ethnic quartz pillars. I love the way they look with the little diamonds in them, so that's why I've been using it. And I've just been getting kind of throwing glowstone textures everywhere. Like, you'll notice each little area has a different glowstone texture. I haven't done anything really back here except for I moved our water mills back here to get them the fuck out of the way. I made a new endercate because I broke the last one we had. And I upgraded our solar panels to tier 5. Now, you'll notice we don't have an ME system here anymore. And that is because we have an ME system down here. So, I know this, there's a lot going in this room, but basically I found these Futura blocks that look really cool, and I did the outside of it, and I was like, oh, that's cool, and then I put the ME controllers down, and I like went around with that, and it was really cool, and then I went around the glowstone, and then I had to make it match, so I made Futura blocks that look like ME controllers. These aren't real, these are just, it's just a retexture of these blocks. And then I had to find something in the middle So I used the blue ones, and I don't like it, but that's what we've got. So I guess starting here, or actually I'll start here. So we have our three crafting grids that we've always had. I don't know why are we losing power? Why are we out of power? What? We're out of power for some reason. Let's kill that. Why is it not? Okay. Let's break that. We'll let it catch up a little bit. Oh, I know why we're losing so much power. Let me fix that. Now we shouldn't be losing as much power. So I did set up a wireless thing here. Actually, let's go back to here. So we have our three crafting grids. We have our ME controllers. We have our storage, same one. We have 1K, 16K. I just added another co-processing to make it look the same. And then we have a bunch of interfaces here. And then each one of these interfaces has a molecular assembler in the middle of it. And basically, I'm just going to stack them on this wall. And then when I run out of room, I'll build an area for them. But until then, they're getting stuck there. And then we have our disk drives. This is just how many I had made. So I put them up. We have a network, or we have a security terminal. We have a wireless access point. And then this is where our crystal growth chamber is. And then here is our inscribers. And I actually got it fully automated. So I marked them. So this one's gold, this is diamond, this is silicon, and this is pure Certus. So you put the items in up top, it makes the processors, they come into here, and then you put redstone in here and it auto combines in here, and then they come out here. I'm gonna go through the filters real quick. The only thing you have to do is filter this. These don't have to have filters on them. It's just extract, insert, and then this just extracts, inserts. So you'll notice these are all on the side. This is the way you have to put them. Okay? So our first filter here. These are all of our circuits. Okay? So all the circuits get put in here. This is third priority. Because inscribers apparently have priority now. I did not know this, but apparently they do. Directly under the chest, we have our redstone. So it gets put in first and goes to the middle slot. So the middle is first, this is second, this is third. Up here, we have our printed silicon and it gets put in. And then we're just extracting and going into this chest. So next thing, you'll notice that if I hit tilde, we have a wireless crafting terminal. I did make one of those. They're not that bad to make. The one I have right now is this one, which is just the basic one, which is just a wireless terminal, dense energy cell. And so you take that, you put a flux pearl and a crafting terminal, you do this. Okay, and then you can wear it as a bobble. I also went ahead, if I open my quest line, you'll notice that we have a lot of the applied energistic stuff done. That's because I just went ahead and made all this shit. So starting out, wireless setup. I don't know what this does, but I made it. It's not that hard to make. Just basic crafting recipes. They're applied. Next, we have our wireless access point, which we had to make these anyway, and then that's the wireless boosters you see me take out. That just extends how far your wireless receiver can read. And it's based on the amount of RF, so the more cards, the farther it goes, the more RF it uses. Next we have quantum storage. I made a quantum storage unit, which basically just holds a lot of items, and it's just, the recipe is really simple. Next we have blaster resistant ME drive. Apparently it's blast resistant. It's just some obsidian, a cable, and a drive. And then we have a flat drive. I don't know why you would need that. And then we have our storage items. We've made those anyway. Our wireless terminals, so that's the one I was talking about that I made. This is the one I'm currently using. And then there is one a wireless interface terminal, which I made. That's pretty cool. We have a charger, which charges the terminals, and then just Flux Pearl. So we can go ahead and claim all of those. And we have, oh, I made a cobblestone. I made the diamond cobble gen. So I have all that stuff in a chest here, mainly because I wanted to play with these two things. The rest of this we can put in here. So I wanted to show you this guy, this charger. This is really cool. So if I put it up here, like so, and then I right click it, you'll see that it starts charging, which is really cool. So, and what this interface terminal does, it's this just wireless. So like if we go ahead and click on this, we can link it, and then we have a wireless terminal. And I was thinking, so this has to be hooked to power. Can I hook it to an ME? I can't. So it has to be hooked directly to power. So we can put this up here for now. We'll set it there, sure. So another crafting recipe, if you see, is the ultimate terminal, which is just the two that I have put together. So we can go ahead and do that now. And then you can install modules in this, apparently. I don't actually know how this works, but it was a quest. You'll see here in just a second, the quest will pop up for this. So we can go ahead and detect that. There we go. And then I don't have Infinity Booster cards. Magnet cards aren't that bad to make. We can make one of those pretty easily. And then Infinity Booster cards, it's a quantum entangled singularity. So you have to make a singularity, and then you have to explode it. And a singularity is like the end game with inside of quantum compressors. So that's pretty rough. So we're not going to make that right now. But what I want to do is I want to grab all of my RAKs, and I want to show you guys what I have purchased. So far, I've got the Magnetized Totem, the Step Assist Totem, and the Haste Totem. I got this one for free somehow. I don't know. I don't remember buying that, but I got that for free somehow. So the next thing I want to buy is I actually want to buy the Speed Totem. And let me claim it. And then there was another one I was looking at. Oh, yeah, I want the Regeneration one, which we don't have enough for. So we can go ahead and put this on, and now we have permanent speed, which is really awesome. So I also planted some diamond seeds over here because we're running low on diamonds, and we don't need the essence, the Certus essence. So what we can do is this will actually let us make diamonds for free. So what I want to do real quick is I actually want to finish upgrading our cobble gems over here. So we need this one and this one. And then we can go ahead and upgrade these just simply by doing this. And now this should produce cobblestone faster than we can... No? So what's the next upgrade? Blaze rods? Do I have enough blaze rods? I don't know. If not, I can probably make some. We can make some because I should have a ton of this stuff. So yeah, let's just fill our inventory up. And then we can just dump into here. And actually, let me get a chest. What is your 2 gold chests? Like so. And then that should be able to push. Out. Can it push out the front? I don't know. Okay, so let's just do this then. Because I know it can push out the side. So let's do that, and we'll just make a ton of blaze rods. Because we don't really need this for anything else. that I can think of. And we have so freaking much of it. I wanted to see how many more diamonds do we have. We have 10 more. Can we make any more solar panel tier 5s? Can I get like one more of those? Because you get 2 for 1, so I need glass. I need a lot of glass. So let's do real quick, I guess on camera, because I haven't recorded a lot in this episode. I got to do something with this fucking mob farm, and I don't know what I want to do yet. I thought about putting it kind of way over there somewhere. Is compact. I'm trying to think of what the hell that damn mod is. It's the one that makes lets you make a machine. Is there compact machines? No. So, I think realistically, we need to work on... I want to see how much I have. Okay, so I have over a stack of insanium. Realistically, I think I want to work on some of the more weirder quests. Like, we're going to need to get into... Where is it at? Transmutation tablet. Where do you get transmutation tablet at? Where is transmutation tablet? Is that through here? No. Where is that quest then? Because I would like to get into Draconic Evolution because we can start duplicating shit. Seven by seven's extended crafting. Okay. And that is under Phi. That's the rocket. So where is 7x extended project Ozone 3 extended crafting quest? Where is that? Okay, so it's a mod. Extended crafting is a mod, so then it should have a quest line somewhere. Is it this? No, that's all of the... That's all modular machinery. Requires 7x7 extended crafting. At extended crafting. Okay, so this is basic. Okay, so now I know what the picture looks like. So it's gonna be... I've seen that picture before. Where's it at? I've seen that picture. Where the hell did I see it at? Is it Delta? No. Gamma? No. Okay, so how do you make that? Fuck it. You know what we're going to do? We're going to make this shit. We're just going to make one of those, and it'll tell me exactly where that's at. Okay, so we need to make a bunch of that. And then we need to make one of these. Is it this? Come on, give me the recipe. No? Okay, fuck it. I'll just make a stack of these. Is that enough of them? So what the hell Alright, I'll bring you guys back in a second once I find this, I guess. Alright, I figured it out, and this is fucked. So, we have to go here. Okay, so then that popped everything. So we can claim all the shit we've done in Ender.io. Which then lets us go down to Psy. So we've claimed that, or we've done this. Okay. So then that lets us, so now we need to do black iron ingot. Okay, so then we have to set this up somehow. Okay, but before we do that, I want to finish buying that damn thing that I wanted. Where was that? Regeneration, yes, I want to buy that. How many do I have left? I have 37. Okay, I'm going to save those. Okay. Let's get rid of... Oh, I can't get rid of that. Oh. Okay. Can I buy more haste, then? I'd like to buy more haste. Where's the haste? There's the haste. We have 37 REKs. Can I buy another one? Will it let me? Oh, it will. Perfect. Okay, so let's get rid of this. I need 63 player levels for that. Damn. Also, it's just going to keep pinging in there. Ain't shit I can do about it. Alright, so let's figure out how this extended crafting thing works. Extended crafting. Okay, so there's a book. Let's make the book. Can't make the book. So it's Ender... Oh my god. Jade. How the fuck do I get jade? Jade ores from Erebus. Okay. Then that is from Quark. Okay, so we might have to do this in the next episode because I don't know what this is. I've never played with this mod. The only time I've really ever played with extended crafting was back in Stoneblock 1. And you didn't have to go through all this. You could just make the fucking crafting tables. So I'm not sure what I'm supposed to do here. Ender bite. Fuck it, back to Google I go, I guess. Ender bitite. You know, it doesn't even, there's like nothing. So they're saying it's in the end, which it looks like an end thing, which that's fine. So then jade is from Erebus. But it doesn't tell you where to get it. And I don't think I've ever played free fresh add-ons, Erebus. In the Erebus. Oh, in the Erebus. So how the hell do you get to the Erebus? So, is there like a portal? Or. Is there a portal? Okay. So you need vines, emerald, obsidian pieces. Okay. Offering altar from Erebus. Okay, so let's make one of those. Okay, so I need stone brick. Okay, so I have an offering altar. Okay. And then I need vines. I don't have any vine. Easy way to get vines. Oh, I gotta get through fucking Botania? Or I can do nature essence. Well, I can probably do nature essence. What do I need for that? I need pumpkins and cactus. Okay, so then how am I getting cactus? You do it through. Wait, I have. Do I have cactus seeds? No. All right. So we're gonna call that for an episode. I'm gonna do a bunch of research on this shit, try to figure out what the fuck you're supposed to do, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Bye.